What's good? This hand has two other vials and one island. It seems awesome. Welcome. I'm rocking the Void Mage Vial deck, which I'm in love with. It's just the Sky Hussar obsession. Oh man, this would be even better if we're on the play, huh? Yeah, I just Sky Hussar obsession is what this deck really is like. Just so fun. It's just so fun to draw cards and draw cards. Like, I'm a big fan of it. Interesting. So a black cleave and no play. Normally you'd see black cleave from either Jund or Burn. And Jund has a lot of tapped lands as Thoughtseize and such. So I think it's a little bit peculiar. It makes me inclined to believe we might be getting burned out. Not really sure how this hand matches up against Burn. It's pretty slow. If we get some long games and can reach the mid game, then these vials are going to be money. But one, if they're Abrupt Decay, that's going to be problematic as well. Okay, and that might be the case. Dark Confident. All right, well, we're up against Jund, so time to see if we can hang with the big dogs. I would love a Sage of Epirtir to combine with this other vial to throw in front of the Dark Confidant. Definitely gonna move to do that with Murder of Frost. Like, it'll be nice to have two creatures to get Sky Hussar going, but I feel like we're a ways away from getting there. Really depends on our draw step, though. Like, a land will change a lot of things. Another vial. Well, Serum Vision's just gonna have to wait. A little bit of a non-bow here, but opportunity to just start these vial ticking up seems like the way to go. Meanwhile, we have an absentee opponent a little bit. Perhaps got his or her hands full with some other things. Don't presume to know. Abrupt Decay, that's really obnoxious. Well, I guess we have a lot of vials. Sets us back a full turn, though. Wow, it's interesting. Okay. Interesting. So the opponent could. It's pretty interesting. Okay, I wonder if this is gonna get bolted. Yep. And then Abrupt Decay. It's gonna be a long way to the top, guys, but maybe we can do it. Confidant is a lot of fuel. Ooh, interesting. Scooze. Well, I guess that's kind of smart. I could play another vial. I'm interested in getting a basic right now so that we can Serum Visions and not worry about shuffling stuff away. Void Mage. I like it because we're gonna have a vial on two, and then Sower seems like the way that we could maybe win this game. I could have gone looking for a fourth land. I think that would be reasonable. I'm hoping that all these vials dissuade the opponent from using Abrupt Decay, but that seems probably not the case now that there's access to a second one as well. But maybe the opponent will think, all right, well, he has barely any cards in hand, so why don't I wait on the Abrupt Decay? And actually, that's exactly what's happening. Okay, well, Misty Rainforest can go. We can actually make a little bit of magic happen right now. This Kira the Great Glass Spinner is going to. Oh, well, okay. Interesting, okay. Maybe we should have kept the land so we can play Grand Architect, or maybe not expended a vial back in the day. I'm gonna pass the turn. But the situation Maelstrom Pulse, okay, well. We can actually counter it with Void Mage Prodigy. But the situation is dire for sure. All in on Sower, pretty much. Yeah, that's gonna have to get countered. Put this in. Counter it. Yeah, we're gonna have an interesting variety of interesting decisions here as we kind of decide what to do upon these attacks. Neither of these are wizards, so this is our only option. Okay, so Kira or Architect. Oh, I'm thinking back to the Black Cleave Cliffs turn one. Definite indicator of the lightning bolt that came about later. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I didn't block. I'm thinking about that Liliana at the Vial. Okay, well, Kira's staying, so I guess that means it's Sky Hussar because Grand Architect. Is Grand Architect a better effect? Sky Hussar just seems like it's away from actually happening. Away from actually happening. So I could have put out, also, this is a very complex game, could have put out Grand Architect during combat, humped the Confidant. We'd lose it to the Liliana, though. But then we could have untapped with Kira Sower, with Sky Hussar still in our hand. So I think I should have done that, probably. Confidant off the table, yeah, that actually seems really bad now that I look at it, but. Oh well, still room to play this game a little bit. From the present, it's not Kira, so we're drawing Sower. I'm gonna sit on the Sky Hussar, maybe that can bring us back in. It's a big body, and the draw ability could be nice. Kira coming in. Take up all of these. Opponent has an abrupt decay, which could nerf our Sky Hussar a little bit. Okay, this is interesting. So we could attack the Liliana, or we could just. We don't want to block with the Kira, however, by holding it back, it gives us the option to block. It also makes the opponent more likely to minus two Liliana to see what's up. However, I think that dealing damage to Liliana is too important right now. Attack Liliana. And we're basically all in on the Sower. The opponent has an abrupt decay that we know about. Hopefully, this grows more. Because, I mean. I guess the ooze is likely to get sacrificed to Liliana, potentially. It's hard to say. With the Kira Sower combo. Yeah, and I think this game would be in the bag, potentially, if I had made the Grand Architect block. Okay, the Determinate. So the Kira can get killed, but it would take a Terminate. Target player sacks a creature. Okay, perfect. Sower. What do we want to be sacrificed? The Confidant's really annoying, but the ooze is just too big. It's gonna kill us. The Confidant's not that big. Yeah, Sky Hussar has been a bit weak here, has never gotten to be used. Okay. There's the ravine too. Yeah, there's just like probably too much going on for us to actually be able to win this, but maybe. Okay, this implies the opponent might have a lightning bolt also to kill the sower. But it also means our Sky Hussar is not going to draw this turn. Double abrupt decay. Okay, well, the opponent has a Terminate, not the mana to use it though. So take this. Sacrifice this. So far, so good. We can knock the Liliana off the ravine is definitely going to be problematic. Oh, interesting. So the question is, well, this is tough. I kind of like blocking trading this turn. There's a million lines. We could attack Liliana, or we could go for the opponent's life total. I'm just happy to get the confident off finally. Opponent has still has the terminate and the ravine, so probably would need to draw another strong spell to win this game. We would need to. I don't think Island would really do it. Serum Vision seems good. Island. We don't want either of these. Pretty whack. Okay, pass the turn. And then we have to worry about this Raging Ravine. So we could Sky Hasaur and trade with it while we have the opportunity. Then the Liliana is just going to tick up. And there's Terminate too. Maybe we should have let the Confidant exist. So yeah, we would need to block this next turn anyways. So I guess I'm down to trade. I don't know that Liliana can get ticked up anyways. Okay, well, what's it going to take to win this game? The opponent's a Terminate still. Probably drawing the other Kira. Realistically. Pitches another Liliana and has Terminate only. Alright, well, we're in a dogfight now. Draw, go. Until the game ends. Keep these vials set. Spell Stutter is actually pretty good. I mean, it's just a creature with flash, like, and we don't feel bad about losing it. Any creature is horrible for us. Confidant, not quite as bad. Okay, that's interesting. I think I want to sit on the spread. We could play it. Well, we could play it and attack Liliana, but then it would either terminate. If we keep the Spell Stutter, maybe something. This is another really tough call. Maybe we could trade it. I kind of like the surprise that it affords us. But I'm going to play it. Either force a Terminate or nick down the Liliana. It's a relevant body right now. And if the opponent expends their Terminate, then if we draw a 4-drop, we will probably just win. Okay, it gets terminated, sure. Well, yeah, okay. We could end of turn a 4-drop, potentially. I don't think Venser would do it. I guess Master. Sower would be absolutely bonkers insane, but I think we only have the one. That's interesting. Well, I guess we're doing that. Your turn. This game's Anger of the Gods. Not very effective right now. Plus whatever was drawn. I'm probably going to lose this game, but keep fighting. We go to 6. Liliana gets ticked. Looking to draw Sower again. So we're still likely to yield a victory. Sky Hasaur has a good chance of doing it. We have some good draws. Sage of Epitir, okay, well, actually is fairly good. Vendilion Click. And lands, yikes. Well, we were bound to hit a glut of lands eventually. Black Cleave Cliffs, plus whatever's drawn. Opponent can Liliana to kill this. Each player pitches a card. Interesting. Straight up passing the turn. Okay. And then we're going to have the Vendilion Click. Drawing a Misty afterwards, which you need to get rid of. I think the correct way to go here is just to attack the opponent's life total. Opponent goes to six. We're probably going to get a hit in with Vendilion quick. Or maybe. Opponent's at three, so Vendilion has the potential to be a game win. Lightning Bolt not going to kill us. Courser reveals Inquisition. Is there a land? There is a land. Okay, well. It's interesting. Tarmogoyf. Okay, well, we're in a spot where if the opponent flips anything to their Dark Confidant, then, I mean, the game comes down to this Confidant flip. After a misplay years ago, aeons ago, I mean, I'm sure there's been more ways I could optimize, but definitely the no Grand Architect on that turn. Like, I should have made that move, and I think our spot would be much better. But as is, I like our position. Additionally, we would win the game off of opponent just straight concedes, goes to three. Is the assumption that Confidant's gonna kill them? Just scoop. Well, we won, so. Oh yeah, I mean, we had the Misty, which we knew about. All right, if we can toughen up our deck, that'd be nice. Tidewinder Mage is an option too. I'm not huge on Venser, and I like Master. And Thassa seems like it can't stay in play. Even though Vendilion won, it's a little bit frail. Grand Architect. Spell Stutter can counter stuff. Definitely want the Sowers. Mana. Making our deck more expensive. Shackles, Tidebinder. Void Mage doesn't seem too good to me. It seems a bit clunky and slow. Sage is actually insane in the Jund matchup, really good. I don't think the opponent is likely to be too prepared for Shackles. Tidebinder Mage isn't the strongest card, so I'm going to try just one, and that could easily be zero. Not a huge fan of Meddling Mage.